माइक्रोबियल डिसीजेस चिकुनगुनिया द वर्ड चिकुनगुनिया इज डिराइव्ड फ्रॉम माकुंडे लैंग्वेज मीनिंग दैट विच बेंड्स अप एज द पर्सन सफरिंग फ्रॉम दिस कंडीशन कंप्लेन्स ऑफ पेन इन ज्वाइंट्स फॉर अ लॉन्ग टाइम दिस इज एन इन्फेक्शन ड्यू टू अल्फा वायरस also known as chikungunya transmitted to humans by mosquitoes belonging to the species Aedes aegypti. Symptoms include a fever up to 40 degrees Celsius followed by rashes on the trunk region and occasionally on the limbs. It is accompanied by severe pain in multiple joints known as arthralgia. This is followed by headache, conjunctivitis, and slight photophobia. Fever may last for 2 to 5 days. The joint pain may last for much longer period, sometimes for years depending upon the age. How does chikungunya spread? The mosquitoes Aedes aegypti breed in stagnant water. They typically bite during the day. Methods to prevent the disease. Keeping mosquitoes away is the basic thing to do. It is done by avoiding stagnation during monsoon season. Water collection in coconut shells, waste containers like unused pots should be cleared now and then. Insecticides sprayed during the season may also control the disease by killing immature larvae of mosquitoes. Wearing long-sleeved and full-length garment to avoid exposure. Using safe mosquito repellents and mosquito nets to prevent mosquito bite. Dengue fever, also known as breakbone fever. It is an infectious tropical disease caused by the dengue virus. It is also transmitted by the same mosquito, Aedes aegypti. This is a life-threatening fever, resulting in bleeding, low level of blood platelets, and blood plasma leakage with low blood pressure. Symptoms of dengue fever. Beginning with headache, exhaustion, severe muscle and joint pain, swollen glands, and rashes. Other signs include bleeding gums, severe pain behind the eyes, and redness in palms and soles. Let us see how does dengue infect humans. First, mosquito bites an infected man. Then, virus enters the mosquito body, and then infected mosquito bites a healthy human. Like this, human gets infected by dengue. Bird flu influenza is the flu infection in birds. The virus that causes the bird infection can change or mutate to infect humans. Hundreds of people have become infected with this virus. 60% of those infected normally die. Let us see how does bird flu spread. The avian flu virus is known to survive in the environment for long period of time. Infection may spread simply by touching contaminated surfaces. Birds infected with this flu can continue to release the virus in their feces and saliva for as long as 10 days. Symptoms of bird flu. Symptoms like cough, diarrhea, breathing, fever more than 38 degrees Celsius, headache, muscle pain, running nose and sore throat. Such symptoms may occur. Prevention. Travelers should avoid visits to bird markets of infected areas. People who work with birds should use protective clothing and special breathing masks. Partially cooked and uncooked meat should be avoided. Syphilis is a sexually transmitted disease caused by the bacterium Treponema pallidum. The disease is transmitted through sexual contact from mother to fetus through placenta or direct contact with infected blood. Symptoms of syphilis disease: ulcers appear on the nose, palate and lower leg. There will be damage to organs like the brain, nerves, eyes, heart, blood vessels, liver, bones and joints, paralysis, gradual blindness, finally leading to death. Prevention of syphilis disease: the surest way to avoid transmission of this disease is to abstain from sexual contact. Gonorrhea. Gonorrhea is a common sexually transmitted infection caused by the bacterium Neisseria gonorrhea. The usual symptoms in men are burning sensation with urination and discharge from genital. Women show vaginal discharge and pelvic pain. Prevention: the only sure way of preventing gonorrhea is abstaining from sexual intercourse. The risk of infection is reduced by using condoms. Genital warts: they are soft growths on the skin and mucous membranes of the genitals caused by the sexual contacts. The genital warts are caused by a virus called human papilloma virus. Certain types of HPV can lead to cervical cancer or anal cancer. Prevention: avoiding any kind of sexual contact is the safest way. Genital herpes. Genital herpes is a sexually transmitted disease caused by the herpes simplex virus type 1 and type 2. The infection signs are the appearance of one or more blisters on or around the genitals or rectum. Hepatitis B. You might have heard about liver infection or cirrhosis. It is related to hepatitis B. Hepatitis B is caused by infection of hepatitis B virus. It gets highly concentrated in blood, other body fluids like saliva, wound exudate, semen and vaginal secretions contain less amount of this virus. It is transmitted by exposure to infected blood or body fluids. It is also transmitted through sexual contact and drug abuse. Prevention: a vaccine called hepatitis B immune globulin provides a temporary protection for 3 to 6 months from HBV infection. AIDS. Acquired immunodeficiency syndrome. Structure of HIV. HIV is spherical in shape, containing RNA as its genetic material. It is covered by a membrane made up of two layers of fatty material. Inside the membrane, a core made up of proteins is found. In the center of the core, the viral RNA is present along with enzyme reverse transcriptase. This enzyme acts as a catalyst on RNA, helping in the synthesis of DNA in the host cell. HIV destroys the natural immunity of the body. This leads to secondary infections. Thus, the infected person is attacked by various contagious diseases, finally leading to death. Spread of HIV. However, modes of transmission are only as follows: sexual contact with an infected person, transfusion of infected blood, sharing of needles and syringes with an infected person, from an infected mother to the embryo through placenta. Prevention: there is no medicine for AIDS. Avoiding sex with multiple partners. abstaining from drug use or use of other skin piercing instruments unless absolutely necessary, that is medical emergency. Avoiding contact with body fluids. These are the three A's of HIV prevention.